Marjorie Taylor Greene is still taking a hell of a lot of heat over her national divorce plan that she revealed this week. And even though on Monday when she announced it, she did say, like, everybody I talk to agrees with this. Turns out that maybe she's not talking to the right people, because pretty much everybody, including all prominent Republicans and her former friends, completely 100% disagree with her idiotic plan. And most recently, it was Matt Gaetz who went on Fox News to talk about what a silly idea this national divorce is. Gaetz said the following on Fox News to Laura Ingram, who Ingram also, by the way, is against this national divorce idea. Gaetz said, quote, "I'm not for a national divorce, but I do think the federal government should have to spend the night on the couch for a while. I believe that the best pushback is a national renewal, not a national divorce, something that Marjorie Taylor Greene is certainly helping to inspire." So, okay, listen, that is mild criticism. It's really not even an attack, okay? It's not even something Marjorie Taylor Greene should have, if she were a rational thinking person. She should have just let it be. And to be honest, you know, his corny joke aside about maybe they should sleep on the couch, a national renewal, I'm not quite sure what he means by that. But if he's talking about maybe trying to get people to come together more, maybe ending some of this partisanship over literally everything in this country, then yes, that is something we should be working towards. For example, you know, take the pandemic. Science was politicized. The left believed in it. The right couldn't believe in it because the left did. Same thing with climate change and so many other issues. So yeah, we do need to kind of separate some things from politics because everything has become too politicized. So if that's the national renewal you're talking about, sure. But it's probably not, because you're not that bright, in my opinion. But Marjorie Taylor Greene, of course, found Gaetz' comments because he posted them on Twitter, the video clip. And so she quote tweets him and goes on this long rant, just trashing the hell out of him, saying this, quote, "There is a failure for many to realize Americans are giving up because they are sick of the talking heads that just complain about all the problems and politicians that never fix anything, while the right just keeps taking the beatings and abuse from the left. Reducing the power and size of the federal government and giving more to the states in order to protect ourselves and our kids from the abusive left is actually the bold action that needs to be taken in order for the left to be able to realize how insane and abusive they have become." Again, the gaslighting from her is insane. And it pisses me off, which is what gaslighting is supposed to do. Anyway, "Just like the prodigal son, once the left gets to truly live in their own filth they have created without us, then they will be able to realize the error of their ways. Until then, most of us don't want to be forced to accept and live in their filthy, abusive ways with them anymore." You live in a red state, dipshit. Do you know that, Marjorie? Like, are you fully aware that you are living in a red state that has been solidly run by Republicans at the state level for many decades? You know that? Because I don't think you do. Also, by the way, plenty of economists and experts have actually analyzed your idiotic little plan for a national divorce this week. And it turns out that red America, like if we did split into red states being countries and blue states being countries run by themselves, red states would go bankrupt within 2 years. Y'all would have such horrible labor conditions, because suddenly all of the things that are produced in the blue states, which are then shipped to the red states for manufacturing because labor is cheaper down here, suddenly the blue states wouldn't have to send it down here for the cheap labor to assemble it. They would be competing on the international stage. So instead of, you know, parts being made in, let's say, upstate New York and sent down to Alabama for manufacturing because the labor is a little cheaper down here, New York could be like, well, hold up, I'm not obligated to do that anymore. I could send it over to China and save even more money. So for Alabama, these other red states to compete with that labor market, they would have to reduce their wages, which would create rampant poverty to the point where people wouldn't be able to survive in the red states. That is actually the analysis from the economists who decided to look into this. Red America would be dead within 2 years. So Marjorie, if you really want to push that, I suggest you look at the studies because people have thought of this before. Red America, y'all are the takers. You're not the makers. You know, to borrow that old phrase. So be careful what you wish for, because you just might get it, and it's not going to be what you expect.
What are you doing? It's over. The video's over. I'm done complaining about everything, and that's it. The end. Leave. Well, okay, if you're going to stick around, maybe you should give us a like, a comment, a share, or just subscribe to stay connected with all of our content. Or maybe you should consider becoming a member for some exclusive content and perks. Just follow the link in the description. Now, go. Just go.